just couldn't believe what I saw.
Clarence Humphrey has lived in this tight-knit neighborhood for 43 years and never seen heartbreak like this. Around 2 this morning, he heard sirens.
And I got up to see what it was all about. When I looked out my window, I saw their house. Flames about 20 to 30 feet high coming out of the roof.
It was another neighbor who called 911.
There's a couple first responders that live just down the street. They're here within a matter of minutes. When they arrive, the house is fully engulfed.
36-year-old Chad Watson and his 11-year-old daughter Kylie were outside, both badly burnt. Watson told crews everyone else was still inside, but firefighters couldn't attempt to rescue anyone.
He'd got that one daughter. And he went back in. He got burnt real bad and he had to come back out.
35-year-old Larae Watson, known as Nikki, didn't make it. Neither did the Watsons' 8 other children. Madison, 15. Caitlin, 14. Morgan, 13. Emily, 9. Samuel, 8. Reagan, 6. And 4-year-old twins, Mark and Nathaniel.
He is a preacher and he had preached at our church a couple times, and they brought all the children and everything. They was real well-behaved children.
Yeah, I see them out playing. Sometimes they'd be down in the backyard there where the swings and things are. 3 of them always rode their bicycle out front here and up down the road. Hard to believe it. Those little red-headed boys won't be there anymore.
8-year-old Samuel spent last night at neighbor Laura Bennett's house playing with her daughter.
She don't understand. She's 7, and I told her this morning before she went to school, because I knew she was going to hear about it at school, and that Samuel had went to heaven, is how what I told her. She just, oh, really? Okay. But she just didn't register.
Investigators have ruled the fire an accident. They say it appears an electric baseboard heater in the bedroom ignited with some nearby combustibles.
I just want everybody to pray for the family.
Well, I worked in a coal mine 20 years and never saw much more than a cut finger. And then something like this in my own backyard.
Look closely in this rubble and you'll see reminders of this home's smallest occupants. There's brightly colored clothes and outside, bicycles left on the grass. Dwayne Harvey, the chief of Graham's Volunteer Fire Department, had seen the bicycles before and the kids riding them.
I just live a block away.
In fact, Harvey was the first on scene.
The fire was on that end of the house.
Making it here before fire trucks, he was helpless.
The father and he confirmed that there were still patients inside, and from that point on it seemed like eternity.
Inside, mom Nikki, just 35 years old, 15-year-old Madison, 14-year-old Caitlin, 13-year-old Morgan, 9-year-old Emily, 8-year-old Samuel, 6-year-old Reagan, and Mark and Nathaniel, the 4-year-old twins. 36-year-old Chad Watson and 11-year-old Kylie managed to make it to safety. They came here to Bow Grove's home for help. Chad Watson, he said, suffered severe burns trying to save his family.
He just said they're gone. He just said they're gone.
Grove says he tried to make it inside the home, too.
That was my biggest fear, hearing somebody holler and not being able to get to them.
But what he heard was worse. Silence. A mother and her 8 children were gone. Victims, the fire marshal says, of a baseboard heater. One of the youngest was Samuel. Today, his best friend, Brooklyn, found out he wouldn't be at school.
I told her this morning before she went to school, because I knew she was going to hear about it at school, and that Samuel had went to heaven, is how what I told her. She just, oh, really? Okay. But she just didn't register.
And for many, it just isn't. Chief Harvey says he was supposed to save this family, and he couldn't.
It's something we have to face. You know, we're not superheroes. We're firefighters.
Well, this is a tragedy that's going to rock the whole neighborhood. I mean, it's just something we don't deal with on an everyday basis.
Jerry Eads, a lifelong resident in Muhlenberg County, had advised the father of the Watson family during his search to find a church in the area to minister in.
But he'd been a young minister, and they'd been back in the community, I think, about 18 months, and he was looking for a church to pastor.
Another life resident, Steve Martin, remembers being inside the home years earlier.
I've been in that home. But I don't, you know, it's been years ago and I don't recall it now.
Since he's lived in Muhlenberg County, he can't remember such a dark day like this in his 63 years.
It's just devastating to have 8 children lost, you know, in a single house. I've worked on the phone in that house before. I've worked 36 years for AT&T.
In that time, he understands that tragedy knows no bounds.
Nobody's immune to tragedy, but it struck right here at home now.
And Jerry not only remembers the family, but the men and women who had to respond and try to save the family in horrific moments.
And those who are first responders, they have to deal with this too. It's a tough situation. And God's the only one that can help us through these things right now.
This is a high school many of the Watson kids won't ever attend, but it's where hundreds came to remember them. Inside, 9 caskets belonging to Mother Nikki Watson and 8 of her children. The family was killed last Thursday morning when a baseboard heater caught the family's Depoy home on fire.
I would describe them as a very close-knit, loving family. They really did a lot of things together. They really stayed together, and the children played a lot together with one another and just really loved one another.
So Dan Pentamone thought it was fitting the family be remembered together. He served as the family's pastor during their time in Kansas City. He didn't think twice about making the trip, but admittedly, the father of 7 couldn't stop thinking about the tragedy that spared only Father Chad Watson and 11-year-old Kylie.
I mean, obviously the immensity of the tragedy here is something many have never heard of before.
Inside the high school, music the family loved and touching tributes, focusing on church.
What a blessing they have been to Calvary Baptist Church. Awesome. Chad and Nikki, wow. Where do you begin with them?
And family.
With each child, the love for the previous child didn't diminish. In fact, their hearts opened wider to give even more love.
Today, Dan Pentamone noticed it was the community that opened their hearts wide, gathering not to remember tragedy, but to celebrate life.
We don't forget, we don't want to forget the Watsons and their Chad and Kylie and those that they lost in the fire, but yeah, we do have to go on, and I think something like this helps.
Lauren Adams, WLKY News.
A cheerful welcome after a solemn goodbye. A week ago, this town laid 9 of its own to rest, Nikki Watson and 8 of her children.
It has been very, very difficult.
A family of 11 became just 2.
Everyone in this community has been praying for them every day.
11-year-old Kylie Watson and her father, Chad, the only survivors of a fire that ravaged their home and family last month.
Just a few days ago, they were so critical, and we were all praying that she was going to recover, she and her dad.
Chad and Kylie were being cared for at a Nashville hospital. Thursday, Chad was released, and Friday, Kylie was. Saturday, they came home.
It is a very cold day, but there are a lot of warm hearts here today, and we're just bubbling over with joy.
From strangers to loved ones.
Oh my goodness, just to see their faces.
Dozens lined the street dressed in Kylie's favorite color purple, waiting on the daughter and father's arrival.
We're just here for each other. That's just how we are here in Muhlenberg County.
We're just willing to do anything we can to help them to make it through this time of need.
From tears to cheers.
We're smiling very big. I know this meant a lot to them.
A community helping a family drive forward on a rocky road.
Kylie has a long road ahead of her. This is just the beginning of her healing emotionally. And this is just one way of us letting her know that she's not alone, that the community is behind her.
Erica Coghill, WLKY News. Steve, what Chad and his daughter experienced is anyone's worst nightmare, but he says what's helping them through is God. He requested we not put his face on camera because he didn't want this event to be about him, and we respected that. A town let down by tragedy is uplifted by a man who lost the most, his wife and 8 children, a void he's filling with faith.
They were gifts from God. That hasn't changed. For whatever time he allowed me to have them, they were good gifts to me.
While Chad Watson delivered an inspiring sermon to hundreds, his cousin Adam Brown says his journey thus far has not been without tears.
That positivity comes in huge waves of grief.
I cannot begin to describe the hole that exists. It can't.
A life he and his high school sweetheart built together.
But we love each other as deeply as 2 teenagers can love each other.
A family, Chad admits, didn't have much, but they had each other.
To me, I was more blessed than anyone. That night, felt it all taken away in a moment.
His burned and bandaged hands serve as a constant reminder of what happened.
That night, running around in the neighbor's living room, chasing my daughter as we saw the flesh dripping off our hands.
His daughter, Kylie, the only other survivor at just 11, is also dealing with the pain.
She misses her mother, and she misses her brothers and sisters, but overall, she's a pretty tough gal.
As the father-daughter duo tough it out, they give thanks along the way.
How you honored my family. How you softened our sorrow.
A hurt now healing with the help of faith, friends, and a newfound family in this community. Chad and his daughter Kylie are now staying with Chad's cousin Adam. The home they lived in before has since been demolished. There are plans in the works to build a memorial park on the property where their home once stood. Erica Coghill, WLKY News.